Because I'm comfortable where I am. I am happy where I am. I love making videos with my friends. But will I love it when I'm older? That is the question.
I've been making videos since I was 12, and I don't know how to feel about the way I turned out.
Just because you would suck at creating content doesn't mean I suck too.
You keep watching people get canceled for things that you believe in yourself, but you're just too scared to say it.
I get the tower like Skeeter, swerving through lanes, I am limitless. For the ones down, I said free up. I start to question what freedom is. My aunt put the Chevy on foes. I dripping all black like an emo bitch.
Boy! Y'all just wait till someone ain't affecting the stock and y'all just take them out one by one to impose fear on anybody with freedom of thought.
Feels like I've been making content forever and like I just started because I never gave myself a chance to fail and learn. My end goal was to stand out as the best creator in every single room I was in. I just wanted to be praised for how mature and creative I was for my age. But maturity is admitting how little you actually know about life.
Like, I honestly, like, I admire his dedication to the channel, even though it's, like, not that big.
Good morning. Let's give this dude a fresh cut before we start the day.
Hold up. Ooh. You see that?
Hold on, let's give him cornrows.
Ooh. It's not cultural appropriation. Calm down, he's a bear.
Oh, you didn't tell me he was wavy like that.
Honey bear, why do you have more drip than me?
Oh, shit!
I knew how valuable childhood was, so I spent as much of it as possible on making a timeless collection of videos I could enjoy forever. Okay. I put all my effort into videos that would make you respect me as a creator and not see me as the praise-chasing teen that I am. There was no learning process or experimenting, it was just make better content than everyone else around you without learning how to do it first. So where did it get me?
As I've gotten older, I've had to accept that I'm never going to have as much free time as I am right now really, really quickly. I'm in a really weird time right now where I'm in my senior year of high school. Everybody's getting ready for with their suits and their dresses, and there's this big culture around getting ready for your graduation because you only have one. But I just don't care.
Are you afraid of growing up?
Yes.
Do you think the circle of popular kids is all just one big performance, but everyone actually hates each other?
Yeah, probably.
I don't know. Maybe unlike them, I never romanticized high school before I got there. I was scared to death of it. And so I never romanticized anything that had to do with prom or dresses or graduation. I think of all that and I just feel nothing. It feels like it's the most important thing right now, but I just know that we're all gonna grow up and realize that none of it even matters. So what's the point?
Fine niggas talking that cash shit, knowing damn well niggas don't have shit. That's why nigga don't flash shit, cause niggas pulling up with mad sticks. I'm the nigga walking through the mist, still with what alive from the depths of the abyss.
I overthought about this video so much, to tell you the truth, because I always start thinking about videos from the perspective of me, the creator. But I've been trying to get rid of that mindset for a year because it always results in me making flawed stuff. So I was like, okay, I'll start to think about it from the perspective of people that know me. But that doesn't matter either, because I'm making videos for the entire internet. It doesn't matter what these local people in my life think about it. So I started thinking about what would the creators that I get inspired by think about this video. But that doesn't work either because it's such an unreachable standard of content for me. They're in like their mid-20s, mid-30s, and I'm a 17-year-old trying to create the same things that they are. And then I realized that the biggest flaw with all these different ways of thinking about it was that people cared. That was the biggest lie that I was telling myself, is that people cared that much. And you don't, and that's fine. I guess I just have to earn that.
Now, I have this crippling fear of failure that comes from the standard I set of making my best work over and over and over.
I'm just not taken seriously, like at all. I don't know if it's because my age or I look like a really tall 8-year-old, but people just assume that my stuff is bad, never give it a chance because of the way I act or the way I look. Like, bro, I've had people tell me that they don't care about my YouTube channel, and I ask, what YouTube channel? And they know the words Ethan Wingrove TV by heart. Like, look, just because you would suck at making content and we're the same age doesn't mean I do too.
And my self-esteem is only ego to you because you hate yourself. Get out of here.
Another thing I've realized is even if you're not acting in a super people-pleasing polite way, everyone else is gonna be too polite to ever call you out on it. You might get the silent, like, you know, side eye from people who don't want to be rude, but that's exactly what they're being. They don't want to be rude, and so they're never going to call you out for doing anything. If they actually have something to say, then they can say it to you. But just going like, isn't going to do shit to me. Like, what's the worst they're going to do? They're going to gossip behind your back, maybe call you a dick in a group chat? Keep them talking.
Yo, can I ask you something really quick? Who's the GOAT YouTuber?
Ethan Wingrove.
You're calling me not a hard worker?
I'm saying that you could just say no to me, you know?
Something else that pisses me off is that some people don't realize that for big companies that they love, diversity is just a business strategy and it's not actual progress. They're hiring literally based on race and gender, so their website looks the most progressive. They don't care about being progressive, they care about taking money from you.
You're a phony, a fake.
If being PC suddenly got outlawed by Twitter, all the companies would follow suit in like a month, because they never cared about being progressive in the first place. They're like that one kid that would repeat someone else's joke, thinking everyone was gonna laugh again. It's the most obvious form of people pleasing, but we just don't recognize it. Probably because we do the same thing. People will say race and gender don't matter and then treat people differently based on their race and gender, but only in a way that makes them look progressive. None of it is progressive. Either it all matters or it doesn't matter. Don't they teach us that in like the first grade? Don't judge people based on their race or gender. I don't. And am I crazy for that? Look how diverse our team is. Look how well we hired people based specifically on race and gender so our website looks the best over actually hiring them based on how well they do their job. Look at us. Give us your money. Put it down on the tosses, I'm responsible. Bitch, don't throw my numbers. Bad bitch,
wearing a different bag and I'm a bitch. So, where do I go from here? I don't know.
I wanted the mindset of an adult and the freedom of childhood at the same time. That meant never really getting over my insecurities and self-doubt and having to deal with them when they came back as I got older. I'm just so done with trying to impress people.
I shouldn't be thinking about how I'm confused on how to live my life properly, you know, because I'm still in my childhood, so I should just enjoy it, not think about it too much, and do what currently makes me happy.
Because the last thing I want to do is look back on what I made and see a bunch of filler. Same goes for life in general.
Just do it.
Just do it, man. That's all he's got to say. That's all he's got to say, all right? Just do it.